places of your people. Spirit, fall in this place this morning. Let your presence just fill us to overwhelming. God, how we desire you, how we want you, and how we need you. You're the reason we've come together today. We just glorify your name. Amen.
Amen. Wonderful day. For some of it's a little tougher than others. This will be the first year that my wife has celebrated Mother's Day without her mother. We lost her last year right at the end. And Kim just lost her mother. We had the funeral yesterday, so I know this is a tough day for her. And Tisha last year, losing mom right before Mother's Day, and this is her second year without her. And I know that we'll be going to a gravesite later on this afternoon. And so this will be a lot of emotions. And all of that. My wife has broke that a few times this week and cried and we've embraced and I sent her a little card to her. I said, I'm going to be there for you, babe. We'll get through the day. But it's a time of rejoicing too. I thank God that she had the most wonderful mother in the world. So did Tisha. And we're going to see him again. But there's a lot of mothers out here too that you couldn't have children. My daughter's one of them. She couldn't, and she had to go through the adoption process and fostering and all of that. And finally, she has three, and she had four, and that one's going back, but she still gets her once in a while, and she said she had a breakdown this morning. And so every mom goes through all these emotions, and then some, you wanted to have children all your life, and you couldn't, and you want to be a mom. Well, as far as I'm concerned, if you wanted to have a kid, you couldn't have a kid, you're a mom.
Amen.
That's the spirit of the mother, amen?
Amen.
So they all come, and everybody's dealing with all different types of emotions. For some of us, a glorious time. For others, it's just battling to get through the emotions of it. But I thank God for Mother's Day. I have a wonderful mom. Just got off the phone with her, and wishing her a Mother's Day, happy Mother's Day last night. Because I know today gets busy. Later on, we will call her. But it's just a special time. Someone wrote, Mother's Day is traditionally a day when children give something back to their mothers for all the spit they produced to wash dirty faces, and all the gum that they held in their hands, and all the noses they wiped, and all the bloody knees that they made well with their kisses. This is the day mothers are rewarded for washing sheets in the middle of the night, driving kids to school when they miss the bus, and enduring all those football and soccer games in the rain. It's a day of appreciation for making our children finish something they said they couldn't do, not believing them when they said, I hate you, and sharing their good times and their bad. That's a mom. What are mothers? Well, mothers are teachers. Mothers are disciplinarians. Mothers are cleaning ladies. Some mothers are gardeners and even mow the lawns. Mothers are nurses and doctors and psychologists and counselors and chauffeurs, and they're even coaches. Mothers are developers of personality, molders of the vocabularies, and shapers of attitudes. Mothers are soft voices saying, I love you. Mothers are a link to God, a child's first impressions of God's love. Mothers are all these and so much more. Mothers are a miracle. They're a miracle of God's creative hand. And through mothers, God does the most marvelous. To me, it's the greatest miracle in the world, to bring forth a child. We're going to be talking about the Mother of God this morning, later on. This morning, we want to honor all these great moms. Amen. And you all have your story today of being offered.
Fragrance of the Lord every time I'm around her. I really feel like I'm in the presence
of an angel. Every time I hold her, every time I hug her, every time I speak to her. She just turned 90 years old a couple months ago. Has it been a couple months? And I know it's been about, I guess, about 3 months now. And we are so honored to have Sister Clay here. This is little Terry Clay's mom. Little Terry Clay, could you and Alita and Denny, these are her three children. I wonder if you could bring mom up here. And let's give this wonderful lady. She's got a ton of family here this morning. We're so honored to have her with us. This lady, I'll tell you, she's been through it all. And she's an old-time Pentecostal. In fact, some years ago, many years ago, she had a stroke in church, running and praising the Lord, and had a stroke. And we thought we was going to lose her at that time. That's been how many years ago, Terry? 15, 16 years ago. And she popped back through all this. This woman is a trooper. What a woman she is. And we want to honor her this morning in a very, very special way. And it's hard to believe that from her came this lovely crew. Well, we want her to have a seat, and we have several things we want to do. First, we'll have Jesse's going to sing a song, and if you can just let mom sit right here. I want you to sit right here, and later on, we're going to show we have something special for you. Right now, we want Jesse to sing a special song to all of our mothers, especially to Sister Clay.
It's almost time to go and meet your mom. she's talking to you. But surely listen close, cause she's gonna teach you everything you'll ever need to know. Like how to mind your manners, to love and laugh and dream. And she'll put you on the path that'll bring you back to me. So hush now, baby, don't you cry. Cause there's someone down there waiting who's on the golden line. And we can show you're always gonna be alright. A loving angel, tender, tough and strong. Come on, child, it's time to meet your mom.
Then the night is alone.
We have a few more things, and we're going to turn her around here. I think we can just let you stand up with us. You can? Yes. I want to. Which one sang? That guy right there. That's Jesse. Yeah. He's our country boy. That was beautiful. We have some beautiful roses here for you on this special, special day. Maybe we'll get Terry or Lita to help us here to hold these. Those are just a little gift from us. We know how much you love flowers. Terry kind of gave us a little insight into some things you like. This has got a special little packet in there. One is a certificate to Josephine's for $50, so your daughter and your family can get together and go over there and treat you to whatever you want. And then also there's something in there, I think it's to Red Lobster. Yes, we know how much you like Red Lobster. Does she like chocolates? And he said, well, she loves chocolates, but she's not eating them anymore. That's why she's 90 years old, ladies. But he said he had to call and find what else Mom liked, and we found a treasure from the Bath and Body Works. She loves that. It's the fresh and foamy. The fresh and the foamy, or the foamy and the fresh, I couldn't get it. We got you a year's supply in here. It'll last you a long time. So you've got all the fresh and foamy hand cream. You can even wash your hair with it. You can do whatever you want with it. It's a supply of my hair. So we'll give that to this small boy of yours. And this is the miracle of God. Can you imagine this coming out of her? So this guy, every time he comes walking in with her to church, I'm going, what a miracle. Only God has humor like that. And so he's that little baby that was up in heaven, he was singing about that, was crying to come down and meet his mom. And she's got three wonderful children, all love the Lord, all serving God. And I don't know of any greater gift you can have from God than these children. They're going to come to share something. I'm going to let you sit over here on the pew now. And I don't know which one's going to start first. Terry, you've got a few words for her? Oh, so Alita's going to go first here. And I'm going to let you sit.
First of all, I'm going to start out. This is something I wrote for Mom for her 90th birthday, which was a surprise. She didn't know anything about. But Sister Roy kind of wanted me to read it because I kind of refer to some things from way back. I don't know. Some of these young people have never seen or heard, but maybe never heard. Abe Lincoln once said, and in the end, it's not the years that count, but the years in your life that count. It's the life in your years. Thank God for the wonderful journey through life that God has brought you on. It's difficult to realize all the many changes that have taken place in your lifetime. God has allowed you to experience many different phases of this world, from Model T's or Model A's to the jet stream, to men going into space and walking on the moon. How times have changed. You went from having no phones to having phones with party lines, where anybody could pick up the phone and hear what you were saying, to private phone lines, and now to cell phones that'll do just about anything. You know, anything you can do on a computer, just about you can do on your cell phone. Use it for a camera, and so many more things. Whatever happened to dictionaries and encyclopedias and other research books? Kids don't even know what they are today. You grew up with handmade baby dolls and paper dolls and roller skates and bicycles. And yeah, they'll still exist today, but they're a lot different than they used to be. Now we have roller blades, electric scooters, and hoover boards that you stand on and maybe press a button and they take off. You survived all these many changes. Let's go through some of the changes that took place in your life. You were born in this crazy world on January 23rd, 1928, weighing 7 pounds and 1 ounce. Your parents must have been ecstatic to meet you, this little beautiful baby girl. You had a half-brother, Lawrence, and a half-sister, Opal, who were much older than you, so you basically grew up as an only child. And I remember you speaking many times of how lonely you were because you didn't really have anybody to play with. But you went to church and Sunday school and you made friends there. At the age of 6, you accepted Jesus as your Savior and you have lived for Him for the rest of your life. Eventually, you grew into a young, lovely young lady and you and some friends started writing letters to dashing young servicemen. Then you switched these letters around and you began corresponding with a guy named Donald Clay, who was a cousin to the other girls. And 6 months later, you were married on August 2nd, 1946. Then the fun really started. Figuring out this married life wasn't always a piece of cake, but you were so in love that you made it through all the ups and downs for almost 54 years before he passed away on April Fool's Day in 2000. In 1948, the first baby came along, Terry, and he was a hump weighing almost 10 pounds. What did you think the first time that you held that baby in your arms? This began a new journey in your life. Were you scared in awe that that baby that came forth from your body, of that baby that came forth from your body, amazed at the perfection that God can do? And then in 1946, this precious little girl was born. Then 8 years later, along came Jenny. And that was about a year after the death of your mom, who you still miss very much, I know. So now you are not only a wife, but a mother with many responsibilities. You have your hands full with all our figuring and fighting, doing laundry, feeding us, keeping up the house. We were a handful, but you and Dad loved us and enjoyed spending time with us and doing things with us. You raised us to respect you and others as well. You took us to church and Sunday school and made sure that we knew God should be an important part of our life. And most importantly, you taught by example. You lived what you taught. You were the same person at home that you were at church. If anyone ever has lived a godly life, it is you. I'm not saying you're perfect, but close to it. Probably the thing we all remember best is the many camping trips that we went on. What a blast we had sitting around the campfire, listening to others tell stories, singing songs, went swimming, roasting hot dogs and marshmallows. In 1965, your father passed away, and now you are the oldest generation of your family. I remember sitting in biology class and getting the call to come to the principal's office and wondering what in the world was going on. When I saw my dad there, I knew something drastic had happened. I was a sophomore that year. 2 years later, I got married, and Terry got drafted into the Army, so we left home the same year. And that was a very difficult time for you. But you still have Denny, and now he seems to be the one growing up alone. But he eventually grew up and left home, but he kept you on pins and needles for a while. We all became parents, so that made you a grandmother, and so this is now another journey in your life. So between the three of us, there are, as you saw in the video that you had time to read, there are 6 grandchildren, 11 great-grandchildren, and 2 great-granddaughters. So your journey has taken you through many different titles as a mother. Teacher, as he said a lot of this a while ago, teacher, a cleaner, a cook, a laundress, a baker, a seamstress, Sunday school teacher, CA leader, just so many different things. Girl Scout leader, a den mother, a referee. But you always seem to find time to be there when we needed you. You've had odd jobs outside the home which have enriched your life and that you enjoyed doing. You worked at Beverly Farms, giving you the experience to go places you hadn't had an opportunity to go before. You made lifelong friends when you worked at the visitor center and driving at the senior services van. You and Dad were privileged to take some awesome vacations together, see some beautiful country together. But when you came back home, and you were always happy to get back home, and driving down that river road, she'd always say, I've never seen anything prettier, more beautiful than this, no matter where she'd been. Even though you had a major stroke on February 16, 2003, which was Terry's birthday, God has seen fit to give you all these years since then to be with us. And we treasure those years. I treasure the time I spent with you. So he isn't finished with you yet. You don't realize the impact that your life has made on so many people by the example you lived before them. People are always telling me how sweet my mom is. And I have to agree with them. You are like a breath of fresh air to those around you. You seem to bring a little sunshine into everyone's life. You're my closest friend, but you've also become a friend to many others and a mother figure to many others. We've truly been blessed to call you mother. So that was kind of what I wrote back then, and I'm going to add just a little bit more. You say, my mother is a woman of virtue, of love, compassion, and unconditional love. She's witty, she has a good sense of humor. In Proverbs it says her children will shall rise up and call her blessed. And today I want to say, I'm here to call you blessed. I am truly blessed to have you as my mom. Of course, I can say there were times when I was a child that maybe some days I didn't feel that way. You're not only my mother, but you are my best friend. So my mother is a woman of godliness. You've always been there to listen to us, give us advice, even though we didn't always take that advice. And there's so many things I could say that I knew that if I read the other thing, it was going to be so long. So just know that I love you, these boys love you. And I don't know what I'm going to do when God takes you home. I'm going to miss you so much. But I'm going to rejoice for you because I know that Dad's your deepest desire is to go home and be with Jesus. I love you.
Say something in there. supposed to be first, I thought, because last will be first, first will be last. Anyway, Brother Roy said something about spit a while ago. Made me think about Mom giving me spit bats in church. Anybody ever make spit bats?
Let's stand and worship.